Let's see another illustration in electrostatics. What would be the interaction force between two copper spheres, each of mass 1 gram, separated by the distance 1 meter? If the total electronic charge in them differed from the total charge of the nuclei by 1%, let's see the solution. Let us assume spheres to be point charges. The atomic weight of copper is 63.55 gram. The number of atoms in 63.55 gram equal to Avogadro number equal to 6.022 into 10^23 atoms. Therefore, the number of atoms in 1 gram of copper is N1 equal to 6.022 into 10^23 upon 63.55. The number of protons in 1 gram of copper is N1 equal to N1 into atomic number of copper equal to 29 capital N1. Therefore, total charge on the nuclei of 1 gram of copper atom is Q1 equal to N1e equal to 29 capital N1e. Now, according to problem, charge on each sphere is Q equal to Q1 into 1% equal to Q1 upon 100 equal to 29 capital N1e upon 100 equal to 29e upon 100 into 6.022 into 10^23 upon 63.55. F equal to Q square upon 4πε₀r² equal to 9 into 10^9 into 29e into 6.022 into 10^23 upon 63.55 whole square divided by 1 square equal to 1.6 into 10^-19 coulomb. Substitute the value of E, we get F equal to 1.74 into 10^15 newton. Let's see another illustration. Calculate the ratio of the electrostatic to gravitational interaction forces between two electrons, between two protons. If what value of the specific charge Q by m of a particle would these forces become equal in their absolute values in the case of interaction of identical particles? Since gravitational force of interaction is given by Fg equal to capital G M1 M2 upon R² in magnitude, the force of electrostatic interaction between two point charges is given by Fe equal to Q1 Q2 upon 4πε₀r² in magnitude. For proton, Q1 equal to Q2 equal to plus E equal to 1.6 into 10^-19 coulomb, and M1 equal to M2 equal to M equal to 1.67 into 10^-27 kg. Now the ratio equal to Fe upon Fg equal to E square upon 4πε₀r² upon G M square upon R² equal to E square upon 4πε₀ M square G. Here capital G equal to 6.67 into 10^-11 newton meter square upon kilogram square, 1 upon 4πε₀ equal to 9 into 10^9 newton meter square upon coulomb square. Substitute the values ratio 4 proton each, Fe upon Fg equal to 4 into 10 power 42, 4 electron, M1 equal to M2 equal to M equal to 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg, Q1 equal to Q2 equal to E equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, ratio equal to 10 power 36, 4 being both forces are equal in magnitude, Fe equal to Fg, Q square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square equal to G m square upon r square, or Q square upon m square equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 capital G, or Q by m equal to under root 4 pi epsilon 0 capital G, here epsilon 0 equal to 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 coulomb square upon Newton meter square. Substituting the values in equation 1, we get Q upon M equal to 0.86 into 10 power minus 10 coulomb upon kg. Let's see another illustration. Two positive charges Q1 and Q2 are located at the points with radius vector R1 and R2. Find a negative charge Q3 and a radius vector R3 of the point at which it has to be placed for the force acting on each of the three charges to be equal to 0. Let's see the solution. Since the electric force on Q1 due to Q2 is F12 vector equal to Q1 Q2 multiplied by R1 minus R2 vector upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 vector minus R2 vector mod cube. Similarly, F13 vector equal to Q1 Q3 multiplied by R1 vector minus R3 vector divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 mod R1 vector minus R3 vector cube, and F23 vector equal to Q2 Q3 multiplied by R2 vector minus R3 vector divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 mod R2 vector minus R3 vector cube.